Good morning, all of you. In this session, we are going to start with the 10th standard chemistry and physics, where unit number 7, classification of elements, the periodic table, series number 5 is going to be started. Earlier, we discussed about various periodic tables which were given by various scientists. And apart from this, unit number 1 to 6 are available on the channel called World of Competitive Chemistry. And each chapter is made into different series, and each series consists of a distinct matter related with a particular topic, right? So in the series number 5, we are going to discuss extensive study about what is meant by a group in the periodic table and what is meant by a period. Vertical column and horizontal columns are going to be deliberated in detail. So let us enter into our today's concept. First is about what is meant by a group in the modern periodic table. A group is identified or defined as a vertical column in the periodic table that's said to be a group. And in the modern periodic table, there are 18 groups rather than 8. 18 groups are included. And this modern periodic table is regarded as a long form of the periodic table because subgroups may not be present. Each and individual element are categorized into our individual main shells only, main groups only. There is no question of any subgroup. That's the reason why it is said to be a long form of periodic table and consisting 18 groups in that. They are represented by the Roman numerals. Roman numerals are indicated with this 1 to 8. And in this 1 to 8, again, we have 1A, 1B, 8A, 8B. In that manner, again, the subcategorization is given. But later on, it will be considered as a traditional notation. So in the later on condition, what happened, those are replaced with the Arabic numbers. First of all, let us see how this Roman numericals are indicated in this modern periodic table. And this is a kind of representation where we have 18 groups in such a manner, first A, second A, third B, fourth B, fifth B, sixth B, seventh B, eighth B, first B. So here first A is there, first B is included here, and second A followed by second B is included here. Third B is here, third A, fourth A, fifth A, sixth A, seventh A, and eighth A. This is about Roman numerals, but creating some kind of complexity in identifying each and every group when we are applying such kind of A, B, such a kind of conditions. That's the reason why, again, still modification was done in accordance with the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. There are 1 to 18 groups, there is no A, B designation in the modernized IUPAC nomenclature. We use the latest system of a traditional heading, which indicated with the Arabic numerals. So earlier it is a Roman numeral, which indicated as 1A, 1B like that. So there is a certain kind of criticality in identifying each and every group. That's the reason why, in order to avoid such kind of obstacle, now Roman numerals are replaced with Arabic numerals, which are simply indicated as 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 to 8 numbering will be given in the new version. It is a kind of a new version of periodic table where 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. This is the kind of representation. All the elements are arranged in the Arabic numerals and 18 groups are arranged in the consecutive manner only. There is no question here to there, there to here, jumping will not be there. Continuation of Arabic numerals will be there. This is accepted by International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. And let us get some more information regarding these groups. Groups are called element. Different groups are categorized into the elements of family, and they are also known as a chemical family. Group 1, which is earlier denoted as 1A, started with the lithium and ended with the fluoride. What we can say? Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and the francium. This is called a francium with outer shell electronic configuration of NS1. All the first A group elements are regarded as alkali metals and all consisting NS1 configuration. For instance, I gave a simplest example. I'm taking third A group element, boron family, and the consisting elements of boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, and thallium. So this is a kind of boron family elements where all the groups are regarded as elemental family or chemical family. So that kind of representation is also valuable in this periodic table with their family names. Group 1 elements are said to be alkali metal family, and second group elements are denoted as alkaline earth metal family. Here D block elements are mentioned as a transition metal family. So here third group elements are denoted with the boron family. Fourth group or 14th group elements are denoted with the carbon family. And the next followed by will be a nitrogen family. And the next element will be oxygen family. And the next subsequent group is considered as a halogen family. And the final one, that is the noble gas or inert gas, zero group elements are said to be a noble gas family. And here we have two A block elements, lanthanide series and actinide series. These are regarded in this manner. This is about the entire representation of table in the form of elemental family, right? So let us move on to activity based on these groups only. Some main group elements of S block and P block have family names are given in the following table. So here family names are provided to us. We have to do the activity based on these family. So elements, observe the long form of periodic table and complete the table with the proper information. So some gaps are provided to us in order to complete. We have to work on that. So here the columns are provided like a group numbers are given. 1 to 18 groups are provided to us and name of the elemental family is also given. Which element is going to be started and which element is going to be in that group particular. And the valency shell configuration of all those elements to be filled here and how many valency electrons are present in that and what could be the valency of that one. Before going to discuss about this one, I would like to give the confirmation or distinction between what is valency electrons, what is meant by valency, right? Then what is meant by valency shell configuration, right? So here, different groups are provided to us the valency group configuration in the sense their common electronic configuration in outer energy level is denoted as valency shell electronic configuration. Outer energy level electron distribution is nothing but valency shell electronic configuration. Then what is meant by valency electrons? How many electrons are there in the outermost energy level? If you are taking alkali metal lithium, so here outermost shell will be 2s. In that only one electron is there. That's why here number of valency electron will become one only. Then what could be, what is the meaning of this valency? Valency denotes what number of bonds it able to form. Otherwise number of electrons it able to lose. That is denoted as its valency. So this valency term depends upon type of element which we are choosing. So if the element is non-metal, you can go with the number of bonds it able to form. If it is metal, then you have to consider in terms of its oxidation state. That is nothing but number of electrons lost by that particular element. For example, if you consider lithium, how many electrons it will lose? Only one electron, that's why its valency will be one only, right? So in that way, valency is nothing but number of bonds it able to form. Otherwise, number of electrons it able to lose, right? So that is the difference between valency electron and the valency of the given element. So we have to fill this table by doing activity number 2, right? Here group numbers are provided to us. First group is denoted as first A earlier. Second group is denoted as second A in the Roman numerals. 13 will be denoted as 3A in the Roman numerals. 14, where the 4A, 15, 16, 17, 18. All these are the main group elements only. Now let us move on to name of the element, elemental family, which family it belongs. So first group, all obviously it will be alkali metal family. And the second group is called alkaline earth family. 13th group will be boron family. 14th will be carbon family. 15th group is regarded as a nitrogen family. 16th group of elements are called oxygen family, alternatively known as chalcogen family. Chalcogen is nothing but hyperreactive. The elements of high reactivity are denoted as chalcogens. And the 17th group elements are called halogen family. Halogens are nothing but which are extracted from sea or ocean. And the 18th group elements are called a noble gas. Being these are inert in nature, so they are indicated as noble gas family. Right. Now let us assign from which to up to which element we have to indicate in this particular group. When you go with group number 1, the starting element will be lithium and it will be ended with the francium, right? And the second group, being it is alkaline earth metal family, beryllium is a starting element and it will be ended up with a radium, radioactive metal. First invented radioactive metal, it will be. Madame Curie invented and got Nobel Prize for the invention for radium. And the 13th group element started with the boron and ended with the thallium. 14th group, being it is carbon family, started with the carbon and ended with the lead. 15th group called the nitrogen family started with nitrogen and ended up with the bismuth. 16th group called oxygen family started with oxygen and ended with polonium, radioactive again. 17th group element called the halogen family started with the fluorine and astatine. Again, it is a radioactive element. 18th group started with noble gas family helium and radon. Again, you can say it is the radioactive element. So these are the elements which are present in these groups. All these are the vertical groups only. Now let us go with their valency shell configuration. So here first group, common electronic configuration is represented as NS1. For second group, it will be NS2. For 13th group, being boron family, NS2 NP1 differentiating electron will be entered into p orbital. Only one will be there. And carbon family, NS2 NP2 will be the common electronic configuration. 15th group element, NS2 NP3 will be the common representation. And the 16th group elements, NS2 NP4 will be the outermost electron configuration. 17th group having NS2 NP5, more one electron is added to the p orbital. 18th being it is inert, completely octet. We can say complete octet. Octet in the sense 8 electrons are completely filled. NS2, NP6, filled configuration will be there. Right. Now let us find the possible valency electrons present in this. Here you can count how many electrons are there, only one. In case of second alkaline earth metal family, you can find the 2 electrons in the outer shell. Here 2 plus 1 total 3, 2 plus 2 total 4 in case of 14th group carbon family, and 2 plus 3 are 5 electrons for nitrogen family elements, 2 plus 4 6 electrons are there in the oxygen family, 2 plus 5 7 electrons for the fluorine means halogen family. When you go with 18th or inert gas of noble gas family, total 8 electrons are there in their valency shell. Now let us assign number of bonds they able to form, otherwise number of electrons lost by these species, lost or gained. Right. So when you go with the alkali metal, how many electrons are there? Only one. That is available in the bond formation, so that valency will be one. And 2 electrons in alkaline earth metal, 2 bonds it able to form. Beryllium is a linear molecule with a 2 bond formation. 13th group boron, being it is a planar molecule, the central boron is able to form 3 bonds. If you go with the borane, BH3, where boron will be surrounded with 3 hydrogens in the planar manner, so that it able to form 3 bonds around that. So you can say boron family is associated with 3 bonds. When you go with 14th group carbon family, carbon is tetravalent, means around the carbon 4 bonds it able to form. When you go with methane, central carbon is able to form 4 bonds with the hydrogen atoms, so that your valency will be 4 for carbon family. When you go with the 15th group called the nitrogen family, where NS2 NP3 5 electrons are there, but these 5 electrons are not participating in the bond formation for all the elements, so that here there is an ambiguity for different elements in this nitrogen family. For nitrogen only, it able to form 3 bonds rather than 5 bonds, even though 5 electrons are available. This is a very, very important point we have to note down, because these 2 electrons will not participate. S electrons will not participate in the bond formation. Only P electrons will participate, because nitrogen, being it is a shorter, d orbital is absent, will not participate in 5 bonds formation. So that for nitrogen, we will get 3 bonds. Except nitrogen remaining all able to form 5 bonds, so that a nitrogen family elements are pentavalent in nature, means 5 bonds they able to form, right? So this is for valency of nitrogen family. Move on to oxygen, NH2 NP4, total 6 electrons are there, but all 6 electrons will not be participated for all the elements. Again, there is a separation of valency for different elements in case of this one. They are able to exhibit in the range of valency rather than a distinct or a single valency number. Some elements able to form 2 bonds. When you go with oxygen, when you consider water molecule H2O, oxygen surrounded with two hydrogens, right? That's why oxygen valency will be two. But for remaining elements, when you go with the very next element, the sulfur, but it able to form six bonds. SF6 is possible. That's the reason why the valency is ranged from 2 to 6 for oxygen family elements. And move on to 17th group, halogen family, NH2NP5 being associated 7 electrons. Most probably their valency will be 1. What could be the reason? By gaining 1 electron, 1 and only 1 electron, they are attaining noble gas configuration. Rather than losing electrons, they having strong tendency to gain the electron in order to fill the electronic configuration of 8. That's the reason why they are able to form 1 bond. When you go with fluorine, it able to form HF. When you go with chlorine, HCl. When you go with Br, HBr. When you go with iodine, HI is possible. In that way, all halogen family elements are able to form 1 bond in common. But exceptionally, iodine able to form 7 bonds even because 7 electrons will participate in the bond formation. Chlorine will restricted to only 5 bond formation because it is somewhat smaller when compared to iodine. So that's the reason why their valency of electrons will be ranged from 1 to 7. But most commonly observed bond formation for this halogen family will be only 1. Right? So this is the type of bonds formed by 17th group elements. And the next and last of this activity, 18th group being it is denoted as a noble gas family, ranges from helium to radon. And NH2NP6 octet, complete octet configuration is their highly stable configuration among all the known elements of this periodic table. And valency electron count will be 8, but not able to form any kind of bond, so that we indicated as a 0. Means neither lose nor accept the electrons and no bond formation. And this is said to be a noble gas where zero oxidation state is provided. Exceptionally, some of the xenon and radon, all those are able to form certain compounds. But in general, you can say valency of noble gas is always regarded as 0, being these are said to be monatomic gases. That's the reason why no bond formation is possible for them. So this is about the table representing the what important information regarding various groups which are present in the modern periodic table. And when we move on to periods, periods are present in the horizontal rows. When we moving from left to right hand side, all these horizontal rows are said to be periods. There are 7 periods which are located in the modern periodic table. 18 groups are there, 7 periods are there. These periods are represented by, there is no ambiguity, just Arabic numerals are represented like 1 to 7. Right? So 1 to 7 periods are mentioned in the modern periodic table. The number of menstruals represents the atom of particular element decides to which period it belongs. So as the principal quantum number increases, we are ascending towards a next period like that. All right? So this period number mainly based upon the principal quantum number. For example, if you go with hydrogen and helium, they are grouped in the same period. And these two are the first period elements, and they are present in the shortest period of the entire periodic table denoted with K, right? Therefore, they belongs to the period number 1. And similarly, elements of lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon, all these are grouped in the second period, and the subsequent period it will be, and that is denoted with L, and this is called a period number 2 in the Arabic numerals, right? So here you can find as first period elements, hydrogen and helium, it is the shortest one. So first period, only 2 elements are there. One is the first group element, second is the 18th group element, first and last element, okay? So here, second period is consisting lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, iron, and neon. These are the elements located in the second period. And here, this is denoted with L, right? So horizontal rows a period table are called in the periodic table are called a periods. Each period corresponds to the successive occupation of orbitals with the valency shell of electrons. So there is a gradual grow in the electron which will be added to the next level, right? So that is the kind of period which is growing from left to right hand side, right? So some of the important facts we have to know about this periodic table. So in these certain names are provided, and we have to find out what could be the origin for that naming of different segments. Do you know how names of certain families of elements are derived? Families of elements are derived based on certain facts. Alkali metal family is the first group family where alkali, alkali, which denotes what plant ash. So plant ash. So that's the reason most of these elements are found. Alkali metals are found in the plant material. Even in your body, you can find sodium and potassium, right? So that's the reason why these are first extracted from the plant ash. That's the reason why it is named as an alkali metal. Chalcogen family. Chalcogen is oxygen family elements. Chalcogen exact meaning will be ore forming. So most of these oxygen, sulfur, all these are participating in ore formation. So ore and what we can say. So the combined form of metals are found. So most of the metals are found in the form of oxides and the sulfides like that. That's the reason why these oxygen group family elements are said to be a chalcogen family. Chalcogen means what? Ore. So that is the origin to form a ore, right? So if you go with iron, iron pyrite is nothing but iron sulfide, right? Then when you go with hematite, iron oxide, it will be in that way. So most of the ores are made up of this chalcogen family elements. That's the reason why chalcogen name was given to them. And one more, halogen family. Halogen family being it is a 17th group. In the modern periodic table, it is denoted as a 17th group. Halo, which means a sea salt. Genus means a generated, originated, right? So means most of the salts. So most of these halogen family elements like a fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine, all these are mostly originated, extracted from the seashore, sea salts. That's the reason why they are said to be halogen family, right? So here 17th group elements and obtained from the nature of sea salt, and they are called a halogen family, right? And the noble gases. Why these noble gases? Eighteenth group of new periodic table was named as a noble gas elements. Why this name was given? Noble gases are denoted as 18th in the new version. Earlier it will be in the Roman numerals, it will be 8A. Are chemically least reactive, means inert in nature. That's the reason why these are said to be noble gases. And there are outer shell electronic configuration is a completely filled, that is NS2NP6 configuration, hence octet rule purely based on the completely filled electronic configuration of these noble gases only. So that's the reason why all the other elements except the noble gas, all the other elements having tendency to attain this noble gas configuration because they are having very stable octet rule, right? So this is about the naming of various family elements which are present in the new periodic table.